Hello friends, good morning. You might be hearing a background sound of water gushing through this river. I am at a river that is just nearby the IIT Mandi, Himachal Pradesh. Dear friends, it's a beautiful morning. Sun is just coming out from the clouds and I am recording a video for your lecture. So the topic of the discussion of this video will be history of applied psychology. You very well know the psychology has very less or less years in its pocket, or you can call it as a psychology is a younger discipline and thereby applied psychology. I want to make it very clear, applied psychology is an umbrella term, which means it is not a specific branch of psychology, whereas it encompasses everything where the principles and theories of psychology are being applied in real life. So, dear friends, I am very proud to say that psychology is a discipline which is entering and the role has been recognized across the board and people are taking a lot of interest in this. So you are lucky to be a student of psychology. So in this video, let us discuss something about history of applied psychology. So let us start with this. Dear friends, you may be hearing a sound voice coming from the water. So let us note the ratio. We can listen it and we can move on. According to the traditional lunar calendar, about 5,152 years ago, the Gita was spoken on the 11th day of the Shukla Paksha, that is November, December. You call it is Ekadasi of the Shukla Paksha of Magh Shirsh month. This is which generally falls in the November and December. This is a wonderful example where the techniques of psychology were applied and the doubts that Arjuna had in his mind regarding fighting war or his duty were all cleared by Sri Krishna. We call it as a talking cure. It may be, you can call it a mythology or everything else, but still it has some value as far as application of psychology is concerned. So we'll start with this. The next is, let us start and say, who is considered the founder of modern applied psychology? Friends, it is Hugo Munsterberg. He considered as the founder of modern psychology, who first visualized that psychology can be applied in various fields and in real life. So let us start. As you know, psychology, as modern psychology or applied psychology, is a part and come from Western side. So we have to dig out from this their history, that is from Aristotle and Plato to Pestalozzi, Francis Galton, William Strain, Thorndike and Walter Scott and many others. And then Hugo Munsterberg, and it is not exhaustive list, dear friends. Other people also contributed in application of psychological principles in daily life. They emphasize the role of psychology in education and life. During this time, during the developmental time, several important books like The Soul of Child, William Thierry Prayer, who written it in 1892, Teacher's Handbook of Psychology, James Sully, who written it in 1886, Witness Testimony, it's a very important milestone. William Stern in 1910, Educational Psychology, E.L. Thorndike, 1903, Psychology and Industrial Efficiency, Munsterberg, 1913. These are the books, these are, you can say, watershed events in the history of applied psychology were published. That highlighted the importance of psychology in education as well as in practical life. These books, they carried just what these people carried out, their experiments and what they thought their ideas were inculcated in these books, and so that they can be applied in real life and what are the results of that. And along with this time scale, let's hope international organization also formed. It's a very important thing when a discipline develops, certain books, certain journals come out in this discipline, whereas international or as national organizations ready to the field forms. They played their role in bringing the discipline more closer to the people. Some journals also started. These journals, what is the role of a journal? The major role a journal plays is that what are the experiments which are being conducted in the laboratories or in the field trials, they come through the people via journals, via articles, via this media thing. So these few journals, they started. What are those journals were? Psychological Clinic, Journal of Applied Psychology, Association of Consulting Psychologists, American Association of Applied Psychology. Dear friends, these journals made sure that people should know that psychology has so much application in the real life. And very wonderful things. Various people, those who are interested in psychology, they started various studies. You take an example of, in 1921, Terman started with famously known as genius study, which helped to bring psychology into applied domain. Rorschach Ink Blot Test was created. Hermann Rorschach, that marked a new beginning in the application aspect of psychology. Now see, dear friends, these psychologists were so intelligent, they could figure out that through an ink blot, they can find out what the individual thinks, what are the internal traits, what are the behavioral aspects of the individual. They were further known as that Rorschach Ink Blot Test was further classified as productive test of personality. It was an amazing thing. You can figure out the internal aspects, what an individual tries to project through that ink blot. It was very interesting and it was taken with open arms. In 1925, psychology proved that it can help in selecting soldiers for the army. Yes, there were two tests created, alpha and beta. Alpha was for the people who can't read, average beta for who can, alpha was for, the test was for the people who can read. They were those who are literate, and beta was for who can't read. For on this basis of these tests, soldiers were allocated to different battalions, allocated whether they can be act as officers or that the leaders, or they can act as soldiers. So this was a very interesting thing, that psychology principles were being applied in the defense services. So dear friends, a new school of thought just started by John Watson. He said and showed with Little Albert experiment that immediate environment has a significant effect on the individual personality. He said he can change the behavioral aspect through while modifying the immediate environment, that may be psychological or social environment. In 1928, Margaret Mead, so she studied the human population, and that proved that changes in social factors can modify the children's behavior. You can see the images. These represent the wonderful outcomes of psychological research. Dear friends, it was our today's lecture, and next lecture we are going to discuss will be fields of applied psychology. As you may be hearing the background sound, it is a wonderful environment. I can see, visualize, it is in just, I am standing in the river valley, fresh air, and this giving me a confidence and energy so that I can put more efforts. So thank you for watching this video. We'll meet you soon. If you have any or any comment or any critical ideas you want to say, share with me, you can directly write on me, Verma Sujit @yahoo.com. Thank you, friends, once again.